Audrey Wiggins, and welcome to another webisode of Make Something Happen. I'm excited to have in the studio today with me Radhika Reddy. Now, Radhika is the CEO and president of her own company, and it's called Ariel Ventures, LLC. And she's going to tell us more about that and some of the projects she's working on. But right now, a little background. Radhika has more than 30 years of experience in finance, IT, and business management, and is the founder of Ariel Ventures since 2001. It's a Cleveland-based company. It's 100% woman-owned. And it's a minority firm as well, where she provides finance, tax, IT, and business advisory services to renewable energy, real estate, small business, international business, and economic development projects. Now, she also structures multi-layered project financing and public-private partnerships that combine comprehensive economic development financing incentives to attract businesses and stimulate economic development in Ohio and states nationally. So that's a mouthful. She's off. She's very talented and brilliant. And princess, what do you do? That's what she does. It's right here in print. I believe it. I read it. No, but you also have another project that you recently had done over the summer, and that's the International Center, Ariel International Centers. So, Radhika, tell us more about that and give us a little. I've read some of the background, but fill in the colorful stuff there for us.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Basically, I have been in U.S. about 22 years, mm-hmm. And before that, 10 years in India in international finance and tax.
Okay.
And in the U.S., I have been doing international business, mm-hmm. as well as economic development finance for 14 years and real estate for 14 years, okay. finance. And when I came here from India, I felt there was a shortage of international places where people could gather and showcase international events and businesses. So it's been my dream for almost 17 years to
wow.
try to create a one-stop shop for everything international. I feel we could put global, make Cleveland a global city.
That's it.
You know,
global
showcase.
Capital.
Yes. You know, trying to bring all the international events, international
mm-hmm.
business incubator, international companies from
okay.
overseas, organizing trade missions.
Mm-hmm.
So bringing all this together as a one-stop shop in an international center, and that's what I was able to create
mm-hmm.
Only about in end of 2010 when I purchased the old Leff Electric building
okay.
and converted
mm-hmm.
it, and it's
mm-hmm.
been ready just in July. This July 2012,
mm-hmm.
we finally opened, and it's got a beautiful view of the lake and the Cleveland skyline. We're very proud to have this international center, which brings together
mm-hmm.
Expertise in international real estate and economic development. And the mission of this building is economic development through globalization.
Okay.
And it's a legacy that I want to leave behind for Cleveland.
That's
for
awesome.
My contribution
mm-hmm.
To the city that is my adopted home.
Oh, that's
yeah.
awesome. Thank you so much. And then we're also, we're going to show some pictures after the segment so you can see just how beautiful this building is, and the views are just awesome. We want to be able to show you what you can use and be able to plug in to her services. So we'll be right back after this message, and we'll hear more from Radhika.
Thank you.
We're back again with Radhika Reddy of Ariel Ventures, LLC. She's the president and CEO. Now, I wanted to, Ariel, before you would give us a little, you gave us a little background about the company and the project Ariel International. But what are some of the projects or partnerships that you've been able to garner over this past several years that you've been here in the States?
The public-private finance that Ariel Ventures does involves a lot of economic development financing.
Okay.
So we work very closely with several economic development agencies, not only in the city, state, nationwide.
Okay.
In 2003, we partnered with the Cleveland Cuyahoga Port Authority to set up our own community development entity.
Okay.
And we applied for tax credits
with
the Port Authority as a controlling entity. And over the past 10 years, we were able to get $100 million, of which we invest in projects in low-income areas.
Okay.
And so we've done Steelyard Commons, which was a huge economic development project.
Okay.
We've done Miss Ellie Manufacturing. We've done Allen Theater. So different types of projects. That we do economic development finance, we'll do the structuring and bring together investors and various parties to make these projects happen.
Okay.
So and then we work very closely with the city,
the
economic development team, and all the various agencies.
Yeah, so it seems like a great synergy, you know, going on there between you and those specific entities.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So there's a lot. Now, you know, I didn't know that you your company was involved in some of those projects, but I definitely have seen the fruits of it,
yes.
of the labor. So that that's awesome. Congratulations, and I'm glad to know to be able to sit here with the, the mastermind behind some of the that development, this economic development that is so important. So then I can imagine then you're partnered with say the city's chamber of commerce or different community chamber of commerce as well, the Greater Cleveland Partnership.
Yes, we work closely. I'm an investor member at the Greater Cleveland Partnership.
Okay.
They do a lot of economic development finance, and there's some projects that we work together in.
Okay.
And Midtown Tech Corridor.
Okay.
That was one of the projects we were involved to. One Community, that's another one we have done. The Fiber Optic Network. So there are a lot of Cleveland Institute of Art.
Okay.
And so 668 Euclid.
Oh,
so there's a lot of real estate economic development projects throughout Northeast Ohio and across Ohio that we have been involved in using creative financing to make these projects happen.
Okay. All right. Let's shift a little bit and let's talk about, you know, who Radhika Reddy is.
That's okay.
And how you became ready for these things, you know, your credentials, your background, just, you know, really how you got here, how that whole thing transpired, your journey.
Sure. I actually was in international banking in India for 10 years. And then I came here as a student, as an exchange student. All I had was $20 and a one-year Rotary Exchange scholarship.
Wow.
So, and as a foreign student, you don't get any funding, no loans, nothing. So after my first year, I was almost going back. And very fortunately, through the student internship program, I managed to get a job.
Awesome.
Stayed on here to complete my second year MBA at Case Western.
Okay.
And then I got a job. And in 1995, I got a green card. But the journey, you know, for 5 years till you get your green card and get settled, literally you're living on nothing.
Okay.
Bread and cereal. Bread, cereal, eggs. You know, I really struggled 5-6 years. And then 95, once I got my green card, I started my own company.
Okay.
And that's when I got started on my own journey. But it's a lot of hard work.
Yes.
I mean, most companies, 85% of companies fail due to bad cash flow management. But having a finance degree to help me, education is so critical.
Yes.
That helped me, you know, it took 3 years to get stabilized in the business. But it was only after, it's only in 2009 and 10 that I was able to make it so profitable that we could buy a building.
Wow.
So it's, you know, 17 years of sweat and working 80-hour weeks.
Okay, right. I was going to ask you about the time we talked off camera about the, you know, the what you, the investment of the time of your personal, you know, self into your business. And, you know, owning the business is, you know, a lot of times we see the glory side, you know, we're looking cute and, you know, hair and and you know, whatever it is, an office and drive fancy cars, but it's a lot that goes into that. You're talking, you're working 80, 90 hour weeks.
Yeah, for my business, right from when I started, you know, managing a student as well as working full time.
Yes.
It was really hard. I've been working 80 hours for the past almost 20 years.
Wow.
And it's really been hard. And but that's how in U.S. Only in America you have so much opportunity. If you work hard, there's really opportunity here. I, as you know, I came with $20.
Yes.
And then nothing,
yes.
And only because I got my MBA to help me launch my business. And I definitely advise people to at least take some basic classes in finance and economics and information systems.
Yes.
I found those tools to help me in my business succeed.
Okay.
So, but you know, it's 20 long years of hard work, 80-hour weeks.
And here you are, you've lived, you know, you live to see your dream come true.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, the International Center. And I think that's really a key component that you brought to the city of Cleveland. You know, to be able to bring, you know, to have a global center where folks can come, you know, and gather, whether it's for business, you know, activities or even on personal activities. As you know, we've seen the, you know, the inside of them, you know, the property and stuff. It's phenomenal.
Thank you.
Such a large property to be able to bring back, you know, some development and income, you know, into the community.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's at the edge of Asia town,
mm-hmm.
and there's so much potential there. I think, you know, as Cleveland downtown and
yes.
The University Circle area, we are right in the middle, and connecting on the lakeside would be beautiful.
Yes.
I'm hoping that in 5 years we'll be able to have pedestrian bridges walking across to the lake. And I feel there's huge potential. And I think long term. So I see in 10 years that where our building is and the location, that we'll have a very vibrant connectivity to downtown as well as to the University Circle area.
Yes,
that's
yes.
All across the lake, expanding the lakeshore development. So,
okay, yes.
So.
We'll be watching for that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, because that's another area that's, you know, that's very up and coming and just, you know, very vibrant. You talk about the University Circle
yes, absolutely.
Area. Yes, definitely.
Yeah. And having that experience in India as well as in U.S., you try to connect.
Okay.
So that's an advantage sometimes being an immigrant. You see, you know, opportunities in two countries.
Okay.
You see what's good in India, what's good in U.S., and you try to connect.
Okay.
And you know what's out there and what's here and what's lacking.
Mm-hmm.
And you're able to bridge those differences.
Yes.
So that's why U.S. has been so successful. It's always, it's the greatest, you know, mix of people from all over the world connecting to the rest of the world. So it's such a connected country and so diverse.
Definitely like about it.
Yes.
And we're going to take a break and we'll be right back on the other side of this message. Thank you.
Impossible is a word that shouldn't even be in the dictionary anymore. I think that Nelson Mandela said it best, because he said, "It always seems impossible until it's done." It's all about connecting with our clients and customers. Your clients and customers want to feel valued. They want to feel cared about. They want to feel like they matter. The essence of building these relationships and connecting with your clients and customers to create the world-class experience is simply a matter of listening for their stories and personalizing their experience based upon those stories.
Jeff is the founder and chief question officer of Think Again, a speaking and consulting company that helps people and organizations build relationships that drive results.
again with Radhika Reddy of Ariel Ventures, LLC, and she was telling us about her her experiences as a businesswoman over here in the U.S. and in our nice melting pot of cultures, and how exciting it is that she has realized her dream with the International Center downtown Cleveland there on the lake, overlooking the lake. And Radhika, I know your journey, you know, has brought you a long way. And what other things that are going on that you foresee, you know, for the company, or what types of businesses or individuals have actually, you know, utilized the company? And I know you mentioned your credentials, you know, as well about education. And do you teach classes, or, you know, how do you help, you know, give back to the community?
Sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, definitely this International Center is an economic development force.
Mm-hmm.
We do have a business incubator where we are encouraging women business owners,
mm-hmm.
Minority businesses, as well as first-generation immigrants who come from other countries,
okay.
To create businesses, and we are providing shared services.
Okay.
So we have the business incubator, plus we are trying to set up a community development financial institution to get some funding to make some loans.
Okay.
Not only provide shared services so they can grow in a successful way,
mm-hmm.
but always also create funds for women-owned minority and immigrant entrepreneurs,
okay.
to locate there and finance their business. Mm-hmm. And also we have created this international center, which is about 7,000 square foot of event space,
wow.
that anyone can use, and it's for businesses or to promote their business or to have events and
mm-hmm.
At the space. Also surrounding areas, there's a lot of warehousing.
Okay.
So that Asia Town complex on East 40th, the whole
mm-hmm.
area is called Asia Town. It's a fantastic distribution center. So one of the things I'm looking to work with the port is to create a foreign trade zone around the
okay.
building.
Mm-hmm.
So that way foreign companies could come and invest in
mm-hmm.
Cleveland and maybe set up their office in our building.
Okay.
Part of our goal is to attract global companies to locate
mm-hmm.
here, and also set up distribution and warehousing and create this as their North American headquarters.
Okay.
In fact, our first company was a company from Germany. They are the largest aluminum cover manufacturing
okay.
in the world. They exposed to over 50 countries, I think.
Okay.
And they opened their first North American headquarters in our building.
That's fantastic.
And,
that's
great. They loved it. They loved the concept of the shared international
uh-huh.
services, you know, export-import services.
Mm-hmm.
So it's open for U.S.-born people who
mm-hmm.
want to do international business, or foreign-born people who want to come here and start their businesses,
okay.
or women-owned businesses.
Okay.
You know, so those are the preferred categories
mm-hmm.
that we all have actually created a fund for.
Okay.
And we also do international entrepreneurial awards.
Okay.
That's to recognize
mm-hmm.
through TIE Ohio, which is
mm-hmm.
the International Entrepreneurs Organization.
Okay.
Which
so
is the largest.
Yes. Okay.
It's a nonprofit that's located at our building.
Okay.
That is one of the largest entrepreneurial organization in the world,
wow.
in many countries. So
okay.
we try to recognize and honor entrepreneurs
mm-hmm.
who are doing business internationally.
Okay, that's fantastic. Now, did you move your offices are all located in the building?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's lovely to look at the planes and the water and the downtown. It's a beautiful view. I love it.
Okay, yeah, the space that you can really create and expand your thinking here.
Yes,
it's
very creative space.
Uh-huh.
I'm hoping, you know, down the road to even create like international restaurant,
mm-hmm.
like a buffet style for
yes.
the downtown people.
Mm-hmm.
Have a little like taste of Europe, taste of Asia, taste
of fantastic.
You know, the Latin America, Middle East, so
mm-hmm.
different countries, and you know, to so people can come down and share different foods of the world.
Yes,
and also I plan to create like 20 little gift shops
okay.
of different, featuring different countries.
Okay.
So, you know, people can come and have a complete international experience
mm-hmm.
and share the culture, the food, you know, gifts, handicrafts,
mm-hmm.
of all the various things.
That's
so
right. I can see school. Yes, I can see the schools making field trips.
Absolutely.
Of coming down and exposing, you know, young children, you know, to international culture. That's fantastic.
Yeah, because the future is all international.
Oh, that's right.
So, you know, the kids have to be more globally minded.
That's right.
So do the business people. So I think the world is moving to become closer and smaller. With the internet, it's like you're just an email away.
Yes.
You reach the whole world.
Yeah, absolutely.
And, I think that global awareness and cultural awareness is very important. We also have another nonprofit called Worldwide Intercultural Network in our building, and that's to promote intercultural harmony and to help people do different events. And they come and meet. In fact, on December 12th, we're having an event in the, with the mayor at City Hall to showcase different cultures and just to get together as a melting pot.
Wow.
So people can better understand each other and support each other.
I like that. We can bring some interconnectivity for real.
Thank
you. Yes.
Cleveland has 117 ethnic groups.
Wow.
And everyone has their own
ethnic.
Yeah, and we are one of the most cosmopolitan area, but it's not showcased.
Okay.
So we're trying to showcase these 117 ethnic groups all across, you know, the world.
Yes.
I mean, we have a mini United Nations right here in Cleveland.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So
we've got to have some international fairs, you know,
or
festivals.
Festivals and all that, you know. And I'm hoping that we can showcase, you know, each of these countries, if we can showcase one of the events every year.
Yes.
You know, we, it'll be so beautiful for people to come and explain, you know, understand the different cultures. So that's kind
so
of
too.
My hope.
Okay. Yes, and I'll definitely support you on that one for real, because we do need to be more educated and just to, you know, be more understanding. And there's so much we don't know.
I mean, there's a lot of intercultural issues. I mean, in fact, just the other day, we were talking at one of our intercultural issues.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's so many first generation who've just come from different countries, no connection at all, but all face the same issues of language issues, being misunderstood and mannerisms.
Okay.
Or, you know, when you mean yes, you may say no. Because it's just like, I mean, right from the head movement.
Oh, yeah.
Like in India, if you want to say yes, you do this.
Uh-huh.
And no one would understand what I'm trying to. Is it a no or yes?
So in your navigation of your $20, you know, come here, that must have been frustrating, you know, when you first coming over, right?
Yeah.
But look at you now.
But plus, you know, you just have to overcome. Don't feel like, you know, just because you're handicapped, that don't feel sorry for yourself. Just know that you have to work twice as hard and get ahead and struggle. And, you know, but hard work really pays off in this country.
Yes, yes, it does. Radhika, that was a very enlightening segment there. Talking about the different cultures and international, you know, global relations, and you know, in this area being a cosmopolitan area. So we're going to learn more about that, and after that, we're going to take a break, and we'll come back. And we're going to wrap up with Ariel.
Welcome to My Video Broadcaster. This is our webinar system, and it's unlike any webinar system currently on the market. But what makes this product so powerful is that your presenter is streaming live in high-definition TV quality video. With this powerful product, you can share PowerPoint presentations, share videos, share JPEGs, chat, file share, and even use the whiteboard with participant drawing for collaboration. And it's simple to customize, with predefined and fully customized layouts. And you can change layouts in real time. Add your banner, logo, and change the color to your brand's look and feel. Hyperlink the banner and logo to a website of your choice, and upload most major video formats with our Flash encoder. You can also invite guest speakers via video and audio, share your desktop, conduct surveys, and more, with no software to download and install. And only the host needs to have the service. Educators, motivators, or anybody doing any type of online presentations are going to love the features of this phenomenal product, all branded with your image. My Video Broadcaster, available exclusively through My Video Talk.
great segment. Thanks for coming by, you know, sharing with us your company. And I remember even before I had met you at the Women's Leadership Initiative that they had at Cleveland State, I had saw when you were opening the building. I didn't know, you know, who you were or anything, but I saw that, you know, the notice. Oh, I want to be there. I've got to be there for that. I wasn't able to come, but then when I met you later, I was like, wow, you know, divine providence. You know, I still get to, you know, to meet you and to hear about your company, and now to be able to, you know, to share you with my viewers is just fantastic. So I just want to leave us with any last words of advice or anything that we didn't cover that you want to bring out, Radhika.
Sure. I mean, being a woman of color, coming from a foreign land, there are a lot of things you are faced against. You know, there is discrimination, but don't let it pull you down. I feel you've just got to work twice as hard. Don't feel bad. You can't do anything. You're born the way you are. And make the best of it. I think if you let that pull you down, then it really hurts you, no one else.
Yes.
So I've never let any of that ever bother me. I work very hard. Definitely focus on your education. Get some basic education, because that's what helps you in this country. And I feel don't let anything or anyone else shake your inner confidence. I am a strong believer of inner strength and inner peace, and I don't worry so much about the exterior affecting.
Awesome.
So, you know, keep that strength in yourself. Don't let people pull you down, and you can accomplish whatever you set your mind to, and I'm living proof that you can do that.
Yes,
I came with $20, worked hard, and this country still has the opportunity to allow you to achieve that American dream, and don't think otherwise. So have strength in yourself, work hard, study hard, and follow your passion, and do it for the right reasons. Always do what's right. There's so much strength when you do what's right, and don't worry about what's in it for me. Things just happen, they come back to you. So that's something I've never compromised on, my principles.
That's key.
I always keep my values system very high. So you're kind of fearless, and that helps you succeed in life.
You know, one thing I didn't ask, but did you have a mentor, or do you have a mentor now, or a coach?
No, I mean, I didn't have a mentor, but just seeing my dad and mom while growing up, my father was in India, kind of like the FBI equivalent. And in India, there is a lot of corruption and all in the government, in the bureaucracy, but he stood up. He was one of the few people who stood up against corruption. And it was very hard. Even as a junior officer, he was able to put some of the top officials in jail. Even though they threatened, they tried to kill him, they tried to kill us, so he sent us off to my grandparents. And he single-handedly fought corruption against the top officials. And so that strength, seeing him do that, fighting a system, gave me a lot of strength and courage. I saw he, in a way, is a role model for me. And honesty, integrity, he never compromised. Never interested in money. It was always doing what's right. And my mom had that unselfishness and giving of others. Always caring about others before self. So that's something I picked up from her. So between the two, I try to emulate some of the good characteristics of both.
That's awesome.
So
those were your mentors.
Yeah, they were my mentors from childhood.
Absolutely. Yes, definitely be commended. Well, thank you again for coming by, and I want to wish everyone well out there. Remember the things that Rod can share with us today. You go out and you make something happen positive in your neighborhood.